Unix commands. Basically, in Unix, there are 7 types of commands: file management commands, editor commands, filter commands, communication commands, information related commands, job control commands, and some miscellaneous commands. Most of the commands those we use are file management, editor, and filter related commands. Sometimes we may use job control and miscellaneous commands. Information commands, initially when we learn Unix system we may need it, but later on once we get hands on to the Unix, information commands are used least number of times. Communication commands, 2-3 commands once we know, we are fine and we can get our job done. So to start with, let us learn file management related commands. The first command in file management is ls. It is nothing but listing of files and directories. So using this command we can list the files and directories at some particular location. There are some examples given for the ls command. The first is ls, simple ls, no option, nothing. It will display everything on screen. It may be a file or a directory. Let us try this command. I have my Linux system open, so just click on this terminal emulator. It will open new window called as LX terminal, in which I can type my commands. So I will just type ls. Once I press enter, it will display files and directories at current location. Currently there is a file or directory called as a desktop which is at current location. Similarly, there is command called as ls-l. It is used for long listing. So just type ls space hyphen l. It will display the output in long listing format. Here you can see there is some string with rwx given. Later on there is some number, then there is one string followed by another string followed by one number followed by the date and time. So if we look at it in detail, this is a permission string. Later on we will see what exactly permission string is. For now just remember this is a permission string. The next number is inode count. This will also be seen later, like what exactly inode count is. The third string is username who created this file. As you know, Linux is a multi-user system. So the owner of this system, owner of this file, this desktop file, is Nopix. This Nopix user is under the group Nopix. So after username there is a group name given in this long listing. Then there is some number. This number is nothing but the byte size. What is the size of this file that is mentioned in this number? And then this is the date when this particular file was created. Similarly, date and time is shown in this long listing format. Along with ls-l, there is one more command called as ls-l-a. So it means display the list files and directory list in long listing format along with hidden files and directories. So every file that starts with a dot is called as a special file and is generally hidden. If you just do ls-l, you will not be able to see the hidden files. But if you do ls-l --a, you will be able to see the hidden files and directories. Also, you can give the command something like this, ls-la, or you can give the command as ls-al. Both the commands has same output. Sequence of the options doesn't matter. -al is same as -la. Similarly, there is one more option with ls called as ls-lt. T is used to sort the files list of these files as per the timestamp. So if I do ls-lt, I will be able to see the list of the files and directories sorted as per the time when it was created. Currently there is only one directory shown as a desktop. So if I use the option ls-lta, so I will be able to see the system special files and directories as well, sorted as per the timestamp when those were created. So now you can see the latest files are at top. So the latest file which was created on September 25th is at the top. So similarly, if you look at the bottom most file, it is bash_logout. It was created on 12th May 2008. So this is using option ls-t. We can sort the list as per the timestamp. Similarly, there is one more option called as ls-r, reverse listing. So whatever is the list of files and directories, that will be shown in reverse fashion. Like if we do ls-t, it will display the list as per the timestamp in sorted fashion. ls-tla will show the bash_logout, this file at last, which is the oldest file in this list. If I do ls-lrta, so it means make the long listing of the file, reverse timestamp, and also show special files or hidden files. So this oldest file bash_logout will be at top, and the files which are latest one will be shown at the bottom. here it is. ls-lrta, the command which we have fired, and bash underscore logout, which was at the bottom in my previous command, now is the first command. The first file listed. So this way, using hyphen r, we can reverse the listing. Also, there is one more command called as ls a star. It means display all the files and directories which are starting with A. If I press enter, there won't be anything on screen, because there is no such file or directory which is starting with A star. Instead, if I give the command ls space D star, still there is nothing. If I give ls space capital D star, now you can see there is something on screen, which is nothing but the content of the directory desktop. There is a directory called as a desktop. If you look at this permission string, the first character is D. It means this is a directory. Since I have given the command ls dot ls space D star, so it is nothing but this ls command has given the listing of the files and directories within the desktop directory. So if I do ls space desktop, the output will be same. If I do ls space small d star, there will be no output shown on the screen. So this way we can provide the path name within the ls command. If we do ls space capital D question mark, it has given an error, cannot access D question mark. It means question mark represent one character. So this command ideally should be accepting the path which has started with a capital D and has maximum two characters in it. So in desktop you can see there are 7 characters. So if I do ls space d 7 question marks, sorry, 6 question marks including d, I should be able to see the content of this desktop directory. If I remove one question mark, you will see that it will give error, cannot access so and so file and directory. So this way in path name we can have a wild character. Along with these commands, we can also use options. If I press enter, now you can see using this option hyphen A, we are able to see the special files or hidden files within this desktop directory. So this way in path you can have options as well as wildcard characters. Now let us look at the complete syntax of the ls command. Ls command has hyphen a hyphen b capital hyphen a hyphen c capital hyphen c hyphen d hyphen f hyphen capital f hyphen g hyphen I hyphen L M N O P Q R S T U X and path names. I have explained few of the options. Other options you can explore within the commands. If you still are not able to, then you can use Google to see the use or to find the use of a particular option within ls command. Thank you.